The cover for the album, it's really celebrating the 20 years, showing several different looks throughout my career, different photographs that I've collected from major photographers that I've worked with in the past, and working with James White. I first worked with him on the last Blenda cover that I did, which was a few years back, and fell in love with him. Wonderful photographer, and asked him to shoot this cover. I like the feeling of it. It's different. Different energies of me, different looks, different vibes. Historic to me, walking away from the shoot. This is an important project. It's the 20th anniversary, and to do this cover with James, it's history for me. With the boss on my back, he don't give me any slack. Jermaine, myself, and Jimmy and Terry produced the album. They're incredible. Jermaine is a modern day Quincy Jones in my eyes. I can dream about my
weekends. Sounds crisper. Crisperer.
Crisperer?
Yeah, it's crisper.
Crisperer.
Crinkly.
from day one, I've always been very close to Jimmy. He picked me up from the airport when I was just a baby. I was only, 19, 18? To start on the Control album, I flew to Minneapolis. And we've been like this ever since. Very, very close. There's nothing he can't do.
It sounds like it's for the club. Heavy for the club.
Ian, this microphone's too short, Ian. Scooch. Who said that, Jermaine?
Man. That's the secret.
It's gonna happen. Drown out the screams. You still hit me, baby. Means a great deal to me. I absolutely love it. I've done it since I was a kid. It's a wonderful way to express yourself.
My love is blind. Can't you see my desire? That's the way love goes.
Usually takes 3 days. The first day is usually for, you know, her past dancers, her alumni. You know that's what you do. And if you act right, boy, I'll make you. The second day usually is open call to look for non-agency dancers, raw talent, because Janet definitely wants to see every dancer. And then the third call is the callbacks.
Not everyone has an agent. So it's important to me that we do have open calls. You know, some of the kids don't know how to go about doing that, and you might find an incredibly talented kid that's out there that really wants, that needs that chance, that break.
2 and 3 and 4 and hits, hits, back, da da da, boom, ba, boom.
Pay attention to the how we like really hit this. It's very like whiplashy, and this. Okay.
Boom, you make me feel so sexy. No pop, no four, it's just boom. Then step back. 7 and 5, 5, 6, 7, 8. Push, hit. Okay, what did I say about the arms? Go, ah, ah, one, clap, boom, and ah. Cameron, go over the details because you're doing your own thing.
Yeah.
But I know you got it. So.
Combination is taught, probably 6 to 8 counts, and from then on we just keep on cutting.
I really hate this part, and I usually get emotional, so I'm gonna go out.
What do you mean, how about Tony?
I'm gonna go out, and thank you guys for coming.
1100.
11:01, 11:02, 11:03, 11:04, 11:05, 11:19. And then I bring Janet down and we sit at the table. And we look at the dancers, do the combination, and from then on, she cuts with me.
All right, have fun, you guys.
Coming and for having such a long night and for putting your all into it and really great talent.
In the callbacks, I usually go over the combo again or I add on more 8 counts or do a different song. It depends. They can add their own flavor to it. They can add their own vibe and energy to it, but also we will dance as a unit. And that's also important in picking a dance for Janet Jackson. That's what she's known for. That's what she's always been known for in the past projects. Ever since Rhythm Nation, everyone dances as a unit.
This is gonna be amazing. And I lied, you guys got the job. Congratulations.
Wow, you know it's fine.
That's so good.
Thank you.
Yeah! Thank you.
It's great for me to see that initial excitement on their faces and knowing that it's something that a lot of them have dreamt about.
It's so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you again. I know we.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you. So excited. I can't even tell you how excited I am.
Good. I'm glad.
Okay. So you guys. Okay. Take a break. Take a minute. I need a breather.
Shoot. And then I want to talk to you guys in that room. And then we're done. Okay.
I see us as a team. It's not me and then them. It's about us. And it's all teamwork. We help out at one another. On tour, it's a group. I try to make it a family.
Yeah, I took home my mom. She's gonna cry, probably like me.
Janet Jackson is the epitome of what dancers want to work for.
My name is Victor Enrique Rojas Ramirez.
Hi, Sai. My name is Reno.
I'm Misha Gabriel.
My name is Antonio Hudnail.
I'm Jillian Myers.
And my name is Tony Testa.
Okay. Wow.
I just found out I got the job.
What are we talking about, Tim?
Janet just picked two dancers, six guys and two girls, and I just got picked. I got picked.
I just booked Janet Jackson. What? Like,
I don't know. Can't wipe the smile off my face.
I love her. I'm a Janet big fan.
Represent.
It's basically a tight unit family, and that's the way she wants it. And I think everyone dreams of having to be a part of a project like this, to dance for a mega super legend star. You make me feel so sexy. You know that's what you do. And if you act like a boy,
this is a soul death world premiere.
does that say?
Jermaine Dupri, the boss. The song started off with me and Nelly in Atlanta. We put the song together basically just off of our little energy, and then we brought in Jante, and then we took the song to Janet and see if she liked it.
I remember being here in LA, and Jermaine was in Atlanta with Nelly, and I get a phone call, and they're playing me the song over the phone, and I really liked it.
Oh, I guess I wasn't big enough, huh?
Oh no, that's fine.
No, don't play it. I guess.
Is this the first time you're working together?
Yeah, it's my first time us ever working. We've partied together. We've had several parties.
See, exactly. The video. It's like an Aesop fable. But see, I'm still going to do this regardless of them talking. It's like an Aesop fable. And it's very whimsical and colorful, and Hype Williams is directing.
What's up? I'm Hype. This is me. I'm the director of this project.
So just sign my name.
Yeah.
And then hold it in front of you. What's your involvement in this project?
I'm one of the principals.
Okay. And this is the first video for the new album, right?
Yes, 20 years old.
Okay, here, you can put that down. Now we can talk about the new album.
Oh.
And I'll let you read these. They're really fun.
Okay. Why Sorry are you laughing that. So hard? Am I? See, I feel like something's about to happen. I feel like
No. Nothing's going to happen.
Nothing happened. You're saying it
we
like,
just made everyone else
I'm
do
the
it.
Principal.
We made everybody do this.
It's my video.
There you go.
Wanting to do something a little different and a little bigger than I've done in a while, he was the guy to call for this.
I work mostly with colors. I think that's what I'm known for, the color palette that I always choose. And it's always in relationship to the record. But to me, this sound sounds like pastels. So we decided to go with a palette of colors that really pleasing to the eye, and the stuff that we just haven't seen used before in the music video. Usually in the music video, everybody goes after the more aggressive colors because it's easier to get people's attention on broadcast. But here, the record has a soft tone to it. So even though it's a hard beat, I chose to paint my the picture of my video with soft colors, much as if I was painting it on a canvas.
Like a fable, and my love, who is Nelly in the video, he comes to me, then he goes to leave again.
Probably is
I think the white outfit. I liked it. It was real fly. You know what I'm saying? Definitely with the ostrich.
See, you don't really see the Peter people at the black events.
The Gucci loafers and all that with the belt. It's fly.
This is kind of like a access granite trailer crib thingy. But look here, you know what I'm saying? It's like the African decor like this. I don't know if it's worth nothing, but it's up there. You know what I'm saying? It kind of adds flavor to the room. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what they call them, what tribe, but none of that, but it's fly. So check it out. You don't move around. Don't mind none of these people around here. You know what I'm saying? You got the big plasma joint on the wall like this. Let me mind y'all now. This is a trailer now. This ain't nobody's crib. You know what I'm saying? Look at this bathroom up in there. That's solid right there. You feel me? Look at that. That's a standing shower. Look, this is a trailer. And you got a phone in the bathroom. Oh, nah. All right.
I don't know. Looking like we're a little late here. If you look at the time. It's looking like we're gonna do a little bit of overtime.
Are you a celebrity? You're so pretty.
I've got food in my teeth.
Show that to the camera.
I just did.
You what?
Food. I flossed. I missed the two front teeth.
Where's the producer?
Director hat off, put the producer hat on.
Videos is boring. This the hurry up and wait world right here. You ever hurry up and wait? You ever did that? Oh, okay.
I'm ready. We're waiting. Bye.
I'm on the set and I'm waiting for hype like I always do since day one. I'm being very right now, but very honest. So I'm just gonna work out with the brown man.
Right.
Oh my God.
That's what they doing here. Just hurrying up and waiting. Everybody come. Come at 2:00. Get to know this person beside you because you're going to be talking to them. This is just a hurry up and wait.
It's 10. We ain't getting out of here. We're lucky to get out of here. Lucky. John, open the doors. I need more.
Everybody, this is one of those closed shots where we don't need everybody staring at who we're wearing. So unfortunately, if you're not working on the set, I'm gonna have to ask you, camera people included, just to take a step back.
He's the choreographer. I've worked with Gil since his first tour was the Velvet Rope Tour. He was 18 when he came on board, just a baby. Very sweet, very spiritual. We're very close, very close. Gil brings something completely different. He's from Hawaii. There's a great deal of spirituality even in his dance, and it shows.
This single is so what Janet is, and the thing that's different about this project for me is I know the beats are gonna be more complicated, but also it's a lot more free. It's hip hop, it's R&B, and I know the whole album is gonna be that. It's just gonna be very, very just dance.
We gonna take one take. We gonna see what this do. If this ain't too hood hype, we gonna get got them jeans on set.
Hype has a great imagination. And a great budget comes along with that great imagination, too.
How many costume changes will you have?
Oh! How many costume changes will there be?
42.
I think there are four. There's supposed to be five, but I think there are four.
So how are you working on your first setup?
Yeah. And my flower shot is ready. I'm about to give Miss Jackson.
1 hour.
So on the set, you do everything.
We all do. Everybody does everything.
Haven't you noticed that?
You want me to talk about what they said?
Why not?
Gil wants me to address something that was said. No, Gil wants me to address something that was said. They were saying, because I wore this dress the other night, this white dress, they were saying that either I had pads in my butt for booty or I had implants.
Oh.
I know, they keep saying. So, okay, I'll run down the story really quick. When I was a little kid, my brother Mike used to tease me all the time about my butt being too big. It scarred me for life. So, as a kid, even as an adult, I would always try to find clothes that made my behind look smaller. If somebody put me in something where my behind looked its size or bigger, I would never, ever wear it. Everyday clothes, tour clothing, I don't care what it was, I wouldn't put it on. There was something else I was going to say. My nickname used to be Booty. Why? Because they thought I had a big behind. So anyway, lo and behold, here comes Jermaine, who likes to play with it, who has fun with it. He loves my behind. So now I suddenly feel that there's nothing wrong with my behind. So I show its true size, which I don't think it's all that big, but I used to. I feel really embarrassed telling that story.
I like the backdrop, flowers.